shines on a world where perfect gladness reigns, with harmonies on every breeze, where every creature aims to give eternal life away, though none of them could die. By serving, loving, laying down, and thus learning to fly.
Hello friends, welcome back to our kitchen. My name is Yvette Simwa, and I have the honor to introduce to you my loving husband.
Yes, Haron Nyamai Wambua.
Yeah. So we've been married for 6 months now, and it's a pleasure to have him join our YouTube channel. So today, we are glad to introduce to you a health series of principles of health that will be in line and will go hand in hand with our cookery recipes that we've been sharing in our YouTube channel. What do you have for us?
Wow, that's nice. So we hope to go through several videos just to tackle basic principles concerning health. We hope that you will enjoy and that they will also be educative. And we hope that you'll be blessed through them. So for today, I think we'll just have a short introduction. And perhaps by next week, we hope that we'll continue posting. So you guys, you can watch, and I hope she'll give us an email where we can send in case we have questions or comments or anything you may need to add, you may need us to add into this information. We are willing to learn from you too, even as we learn, as you learn from us. Yeah, thank you.
Thank you. It will be a discussion. So just check down there, you'll get the email where you can email your questions concerning health, and we will take our time to have a Q&A video where we'll be reading the questions. Of course, we'll keep them anonymous, and we'll also give answers from the Bible and the way God will enable us to answer them.
Yeah, so we are not medical professionals. But we thank God. We thank God. So basically, we shall be using three main, references. The first one is the Bible. The second one is known as the spirit of prophecy. Now, I know someone may ask, what is that? But I know as time goes by, we shall be able to put it clearly to us, that we may understand what we mean when we talk of spirit of prophecy. And then the third one, of course, which is very important, is true science. Now, I must put that word true, because there is so much science that is in the world, but we need also to understand the difference between true and false science. Mm-hmm. So we shall be using the three standards, and those three standards, I'm very sure, will give us true information that can help us to live healthy, spiritually, physically, and mentally. That's Amen. What I can say. Yeah,
sure. Amen. Mm. Thank you so much. So what do you have for us today?
Yeah, I think for today, we will just do a short introduction, and then perhaps next week we'll have much more to say. And as time goes by, we hope to be sharing more and more as God will allow us to share. I think for today, as we've said, we need to do an introduction. And basically, what is health? You know, I have realized of late, people are being questioned. Who is a woman, and they cannot answer that simple question. So I also don't know whether we also understand what health is. Mm. I don't know whether you can help us with just a brief description of what health to you means.
Mm-hmm.
Perhaps
mm-hmm.
Maybe we can begin with that.
Okay.
Mm. So I don't know if someone was to question what is health. Perhaps you can ask your neighbor
mm-hmm.
or your friend if you're watching with a friend somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, what is health?
Personally, I think
mm-hmm.
health is a state of being at ease
mm-hmm.
and being free
mm-hmm.
from disease.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We can say the opposite of illness
mm-hmm.
is health.
Okay, okay.
Yes.
So the state of well-being, eh?
Yes.
Of a human being.
Mm-hmm.
Mentally, of course, physically.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, people are sick mentally.
Yes.
Yeah, physically they might be okay,
mm-hmm.
But mentally they are sick.
True.
And I also think there are people who are also sick spiritually.
Yeah.
So basically that is all about health. Mm. And God, of course, is the source of health.
Mm-hmm.
Is the source of health. He created us. The Bible tells us in the book of Genesis, and that is true science now.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible tells us that God created us.
Mm.
We did not evolve. We did not come from monkeys and apes.
Mm-hmm.
I believe that we actually have a God who created us.
Mm.
And he who created us is the sustainer of our health.
Mm.
And again, he is the restorer of our health. Sometimes because of sin, we become sick. And when we are sick, he promises us. When you read the book of Psalms 103 verse 3, he says that he who forgiveth us of our sins and healeth us of all our diseases.
Yeah.
He heals us. The Bible says in 146 of the same Psalms that he healeth the broken in heart and bindeth up their wounds.
Mm.
He is a God who is ready not only to give us health, but even to restore our health
mm.
when we fall sick.
Amen.
And so we will discover that he who created us has given us principles in his word. Principles that can also be verified through scientific researches, and principles that actually are supposed to uphold our well-being. If we accept them and live by them, they are principles that will lead us to enjoy health. As we eat those sweet foods that she has been showing us how to prepare, following those principles, we shall enjoy life. We shall enjoy health in our families and in our bodies too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I think basically that's what we'll do. And maybe perhaps I can read one verse even before I introduce how we shall be doing it. When you you can, if you have a Bible, you can open.
Perhaps you can pray.
Yes, we can open then, and then you'll pray.
Yeah.
Yes. When you go to the book of Genesis, let's begin with the book of Genesis.
Mm-hmm.
Genesis chapter 1.
Mm-hmm.
We'll look at verse number 26.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, 26 and 27. Perhaps you can read 27
mm-hmm.
and 28 for the sake of time.
Okay.
But you'll pray, then you read for us, please.
Okay, just pray. We're having a prayer. Mm-hmm. Our Father and our God, we come before you this moment as we are about to look into your word. We seek for the presence of the Holy Spirit to be our faithful guide and teacher, to inspire these words in our hearts, and that we may see their import in our lives. May your glory and honor back unto you. Bless all the listeners, and this is my prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Okay, we're reading from the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 26, verse 27. The Bible says, Genesis 1, 27, so God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. Then verse 28 says, and God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply, and replenish the earth, and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth.
Thank you so much. That is God in the beginning, the first book in this great and wonderful book called the Bible, the book of Genesis, begins by telling us that he, God, created us in his own image. I believe God has never been sick.
Definitely.
I believe that when Adam came from the hands of the Creator, he was perfect in health.
Exactly.
Believe everything was okay with him.
Mm.
But because of sin, which I believe some lessons later on we will look at sin,
mm-hmm.
We shall find that as a result of sin, then sickness came and crept into this world.
Mm.
And so we find that God created us. When he created Adam, There was nothing like sin. In fact, I've realized this. Mm-hmm. In the book of Genesis, you'll never find someone who was born blind or lame or sick. Mm-hmm. Perhaps when you go to Exodus, you might find that. But in Genesis, mm-hmm. you will definitely not find such conditions.
True.
And this God who created us, though sin came, he still desires that we might be perfect in health.
True.
Diseases are everywhere. But God's desire for us is that we might be well, physically, mentally, and spiritually.
Mm.
In the book of John, which I believe many people quote often when in health circles, the book of 3 John,
verse 2. A very common verse.
A very common text. Maybe you can read.
Okay.
3 John, for those who are taking notes or reading from their Bibles. And I encourage you, brothers and sisters, as we watch these things again, when we're not in the kitchen now, when we're on the table after eating the recipes that she has prepared, we also need to take our Bibles and study and get to know exactly what God wants us to be.
The spiritual food.
Sure. Mm. And God is so loving that he desires that we might enjoy health.
True.
In the book of 3 John, you can read for us verse 2. What does it say?
3 John 2.
Yes.
The book just before Jude.
Sure.
The Bible says, Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth.
So God's desire is that we might prosper. Not just in terms of wealth, money, but also in our health.
Yeah, physical
health. Physical health.
Mm-hmm.
And when you look at God's plan for us, the plan of redemption is not confined in spiritual matters alone.
Yeah.
It extends far beyond going to church and singing and praying and reading. It goes deep into our bodies. In fact, there's a verse I love in the book of First Thessalonians, chapter 5. Okay. Paul, talking of the second coming of Jesus, talked of the preparations that the gospel, the preparations that the grace of Jesus is to help us. That is verse 23. You can read for us. Thessalonians 5:23. What does it say?
The Bible says, First Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23.
Yes.
And the very God of peace.
And the very God of peace.
Sanctify you wholly.
Mm-hmm.
And I pray God.
What?
Your whole spirit.
Your whole spirit.
And soul.
And soul.
And body.
And body.
Be preserved blameless.
Just wait. Be preserved blameless.
What does it mean to be blameless?
We'll look at that.
Okay.
We'll look at that when we shall be looking at sin. Exactly. Blameless.
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean? But I want us to see those three aspects.
Mm-hmm.
Your soul,
mm-hmm.
your body,
mm-hmm.
your spirit.
Yeah.
Now, when we talk of spirit, we are talking of spiritual life.
Exactly.
The word soul, sometimes in the Bible, can be used to mean mental and sometimes spiritual.
Yeah.
And so because spirit has been mentioned, so then definitely we understand it. To imply mental.
Sure.
That's true.
Yeah.
And then body is the physical.
Yes.
So desire, God's desire for us is that the three aspects may actually be preserved blameless.
Mm-hmm.
Unto what? Unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. I love it.
Yeah. So the desire, the desire of God is that our mental, our physical, and our spiritual aspects may be blameless as we await his coming.
Sure. Yeah. And you know we're waiting for the second coming of Jesus.
Yes.
So if you're waiting for him, if you is viewing, if you have that hope, that desire of seeing Jesus come, him who is to finish all the troubles we are finding today, him who is to take us to that heavenly place, and at the end of it all, restore us into a new earth and a new heaven, then there is a work to be done, that our spiritual lives, our mental and our physical aspects of life may be preserved blameless. No wonder when Jesus came, we are told that he came not just as a preacher, not just as a teacher, but even as a physician.
Yeah.
in the book of Matthew 4, mm-hmm. you can read at your own time because mm-hmm. I think time is catching up with us.
Mm-hmm.
In the book of Matthew, chapter 4, verse 23,
mm-hmm.
Bible says that he went about all the villages and cities,
mm-hmm.
preaching in their synagogues,
mm-hmm.
preaching in their cities,
mm-hmm.
teaching in their synagogues,
mm-hmm.
and healing all their physical mm-hmm. maladies.
Exactly.
The same Matthew 9 mm-hmm. will also tell you, when you go to verse 35, I believe, maybe you can look at that. I think it should be verse 35,
mm-hmm.
the book of Matthew, Matthew chapter 9, just before he saw the Jewish community being like a sheep without a shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
In the book of Matthew mm-hmm. chapter 9, when you go to verse number 35, what does mm-hmm. it say?
It says, yes. Matthew 9:35.
Yes.
And Jesus went about all the cities mm-hmm. and villages,
mm-hmm.
teaching in their synagogues.
Number one, he was a teacher, teaching mm-hmm. them.
Mm-hmm.
I believe he also taught them on the principles of health.
Yeah.
Teaching them. Uh-huh. Continue.
And preaching the gospel of the kingdom.
He was preaching the gospel of the kingdom and...
Mm-hmm. And healing every sickness.
And... healing,
mm-hmm.
not just a few sicknesses, mm-hmm. and saying others are
non-curable
diseases.
Yeah.
He preached, mm-hmm. he taught,
mm-hmm.
and he healed
mm-hmm.
every sickness and every disease among mm-hmm. the people.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you yourself, perhaps you call yourself a Christian,
mm-hmm.
a follower of Christ Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
What Christ did, I believe to an extent, we should also do it.
Mm-hmm.
And this series is tailor-made to help us understand how we can be like Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
Teaching, preaching, and healing.
Mm-hmm.
Now you wonder, how can that happen? God has promised his Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
He can teach us.
Mm-hmm.
And he can help us through the Bible, the spiritual prophecy, and the true science to be able to accomplish what Christ accomplished.
Mm-hmm.
And because of time, I want to say this, as we go through the series, there's an acronym that we shall be using.
Mm.
And that acronym is called God's Plan ABC. God's Plan ABC.
Mm-hmm.
G stands for something,
uh-huh.
Godly Trust.
Mm-hmm.
O stands for something,
open air. Mm-hmm.
D stands for something, daily exercise. S stands for something,
mm-hmm.
sunshine.
Exactly.
P stands for something,
mm-hmm.
proper rest.
Mm-hmm.
L stands for something, lots of water.
Mm-hmm.
A stands for something,
always
temperate. And then N stands for something, nutrition.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have the ABC.
Mm-hmm.
Attitude
mm-hmm.
of gratitude.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have B,
mm-hmm.
benevolence.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have C, proper clothing.
Yeah.
Now we shall look at those
mm-hmm.
slowly and you wonder, how are they connected with our well-being?
Mm-hmm.
We shall look at them and I hope we shall be blessed.
Mm-hmm.
May God bless you. May God give you good health.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I can say, my mm-hmm. dear wife.
Thank you.
Yes.
Thank you so much. I hope you've enjoyed this session. I will be glad to receive your feedback. Just down there, you'll see an email where you can send your questions concerning the cookery recipes that you've been having throughout the 1.5 years that have passed. And even for the series that you want to begin, if you have any questions prior or even during the series, feel free, send your personal questions to the email and we'll be glad to receive your feedback.
That's true.
Yeah, so my husband will offer a final prayer
mm-hmm.
and we hope to see you once again.
Sure, and by the way, we forgot to tell them.
Mm-hmm.
After that, actually as we continue doing that, we shall also be tackling
mm-hmm.
different diseases.
Yeah,
especially
sure.
the common ones.
Mm-hmm.
We shall be taking a particular disease,
mm-hmm.
we tackle it.
Mm-hmm.
How can you handle it?
Mm-hmm.
How can you help someone who is suffering from such an illness?
Mm-hmm.
Then I hope that we shall be of good help to our neighbors, to ourselves, to our families,
mm-hmm.
and we shall live healthy.
Amen.
I am not healthy. She is not healthy. I know you might also not be healthy,
mm-hmm.
But God can help us to be healthy.
Amen.
And may God bless you all.
Amen.
We are praying.
Mm-hmm.
Almighty Father in heaven, we are grateful for giving us an opportunity through the technology of today to be able to share what you have blessed us with. And my prayer is that even before we share it out, may it first bless us, that it may be a blessing to those that are watching and listening. Dear Lord, we desire to be healthy, just like it is your desire. And our prayer is that you may teach us how to be healthy, and that your grace and your power may enable us to be healthy. We know there might be someone who is sick somewhere, either watching, or they have people. Those who are watching might be having people who are sick, relatives or friends. Master, our prayer is that you, who is the great physician, may you touch them and may you heal them. We also pray that you may heal us spiritually, for we are sinful. But dear Lord, your grace is greater than all our sins. So, Father, we pray that you may forgive us and that you may teach us daily. I want to pray for whoever who is listening or watching. May you build them, and every need they have, as you have promised, may you supply them according to your will. Be with us now forevermore. It is our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you.
Yes.
Dear viewer, we hope to see you again. As for now, bye.
Bye. Thanks so much.